Thank you, everybody. Welcome back to the second session of Spring Parasitology. This session, we'll see three speakers. And the first one is Dottoressa Alessandra Barlaam. She is a student at the third year of PhD at University of Foggia. And she will going to present pathogenic parasites in vegetables and berries sold on the Italian market. So, Alessandra,
perfetto. The word is... Finito la presentazione, sono da voi. Thank you, Elena. So, just one second.
Perfect. Yes. And I invite all to turn off the microphone, please.
Okay, can you see the presentation?
Yes.
Well, this is fantastic news.
Okay, just a moment because it's okay, perfect. You can start, Alessandra.
Thank you very much. So, good evening, everyone. Thanks for coming to this second session of Spring Parasitology. And thank you, Elena, for introducing me. So I'm just going to start with my presentation. And first of all, I'm going to say that in recent years, the demand of ready-to-eat salads and berries in industrialized countries has significantly increased. That is because ready-to-eat salads combine quality and ease of preparation, and also they are a valuable and affordable source of vitamins and minerals. Berries, in addition to that, contain bioactive compounds that prevent cancer, cardiovascular diseases, as well as metabolic disorders. However, this fresh produce can be contaminated by a variety of microorganisms, including parasites. This contamination can occur during each step of the food production chain, from farm to fork. In fact, contamination can occur during the pre-harvest phase, when untreated or raw sewage water is used for irrigation, or still when animal waste is used as fertilizer, or when infected animals have access to crops, as well as via insects. In addition, contamination can occur in the post-harvest phase during harvesting, packaging, transport, and home and market processing. It is important to point out that ready-to-eat salads are washed before being packaged. However, the technology that we employ do not effectively inactivate parasites that may be present. It is the same for berries that are very difficult to clean properly before consumption. In fact, many parasite transmission stages are sticky and they can be trapped on the berry's surface. That is particularly true for some berries, like raspberries, whose surface is very hairy, as we can see in the picture down here. The most important foodborne parasites include helminths and protozoa, among which today we will focus on Giardia, Cryptosporidium, Cyclospora cayetanensis, and Toxoplasma gondii. All these protozoan parasites have been included in the European ranking of foodborne parasites. And as we can see in the figure below, Toxoplasma gondii, Cryptosporidium and Giardia duodenalis occupy quite high positions in this ranking, whereas Cyclospora cayetanensis is quite further down. However, Cyclospora cayetanensis is gaining quite a lot of attention in the European scenario in recent years because it has been responsible of several outbreaks of disease in the United States after consumption of contaminated products, including berries, that were imported from endemic countries like Central and South American countries. The resistance forms of Giardia, Cryptosporidium and Cyclospora, called cysts and oocysts respectively, are released in very high number in the environment where they are resistant for a very long periods of times. On the other hand, it is important to point out that only a few cysts, oocysts, are necessary to cause infection, and this is a very important aspect on if we focus on the potential spread of the disease. Giardia and Cryptosporidium play an important zoonotic role. In fact, assemblages A and B of Giardia duodenalis are of zoonotic interest, and Cryptosporidium parvum, ubiquitum and meleagridis represent the most zoonotic Cryptosporidium species. Regarding Cyclospora, its zoonotic role is still in doubt. In fact, nowadays, humans are considered the only confirmed hosts. These protozoan parasites colonize the intestine and they cause gastrointestinal symptoms, the main of which is diarrhea. The most vulnerable people to foodborne diseases are the YOPI, which stands for young, old, pregnant women, and immunocompromised subjects. The prevalence of Giardia and Cryptosporidium in humans vary between developed countries and developing countries. In fact, in developed countries, it ranges between 1 and 2% in adults and 8% in children, whereas in developing countries, prevalence reaches 35% for both Giardia and Cryptosporidium. The prevalence of Cyclospora cayetanensis infection in humans also depends on the countries that we consider. In fact, in developing countries, which are also endemic for Cyclospora, like Latin American countries, prevalence can reach peaks of 24%, like Venezuela, or 41%, like Peru, or in developed and non-endemic countries such as the USA, Canada, and European countries, the prevalence varies between 1 and 5%. Regarding Toxoplasma gondii, we all know that its life cycle is very complicated. That is why today we will only focus on the definitive host, which is the cat, and responsible of fresh produce contamination with the oocysts contamination via feces. We know that the main problem linked to Toxoplasma is represented by pregnant women and congenital toxoplasmosis associated with abortion, fetus abnormalities, and so on. So it represents a very serious matter. Several outbreaks of infection caused by protozoan parasites contamination of fresh produce have been recorded all over the world, including Europe. For instance, outbreaks of cryptosporidiosis have been recorded in Finland and in England and Scotland, and an outbreak of cyclosporiasis was recorded in Germany. All these outbreaks were associated with the consumption of salad. However, surveillance studies reporting the presence of these protozoan parasites specifically in ready-to-eat salads and or berries are very limited in Europe. There is in fact a report published in 2017 in which the prevalence of protozoan parasites in ready-to-eat salads is reported in Italy, and also a very recent report in which the authors detect Toxoplasma gondii oocysts in fresh vegetables and berry fruits in Portugal and Spain. Italy is the second largest producer of ready-to-eat salads after France, and in addition, Italy also produces berries. However, the increase in the consumption of these products in Italy that has been registered in the last few years has led to the need of importing berries from foreign countries, including Central and South American countries, where some of these protozoan parasites are endemic. So what's the situation in Italy? We have some data on contamination of ready-to-eat salads. However, it requires more in-depth investigation, whereas there is a complete lack of data on berries. Therefore, the aim of our study was to detect pathogenic parasites in ready-to-eat packaged salads and local and imported berries purchased from supermarkets located in southern Italy by microscopy, conventional PCR, and validated qPCRs. So what have we done? We have carried out a one-year survey from January 2019 to December 2019. We have sampled berries, and in particular raspberries from Italy, blueberries imported from Peru, and blackberries imported from Mexico, and also ready-to-eat salads belonging to three industrial brands. All these samples were purchased from supermarkets located in the Apulia region, and in particular Bari and Foggia. After carrying out a statistical analysis, an experimental design was set up, according to which 648 samples were collected. From these 648 samples, we have obtained 72 pools and tested them. So each month, per each product, we have purchased 9 packages of products belonging to the same lot and weighing at least 100 grams each. Therefore, we have obtained one pool of 900 grams that was then randomly divided into 9 filter bags and processed according to the FDA washing procedure BAM-19B. At the end of this process, we managed to obtain 9 aliquots, which were representative of the whole pool. After the washing, we have carried out a microscopy investigation in collaboration with the University of Naples and Cremopar. This microscopy investigation was carried out using the Flotac apparatus and, in particular, the Flotac double technique. The microscopy investigation was followed by a molecular investigation that was carried out in collaboration with the Norwegian University of Life Sciences and Istituto Superiore di Sanità. The first step of the molecular investigation was the DNA extraction. The DNA extraction was carried out using the DNEasy Power Soil Kit, which is ideal for isolating DNA from soil or environmental sample sources. During my stay at the Norwegian University of Life Sciences, we carried out an additional research project in which we compared the DNEasy Power Soil Kit and another UNIX-based DNA extraction kit to assess which one of the two was better for the molecular detection of protozoan parasites as contaminants of berries. And the results of this research project have shown that the DNEasy Power Soil Kit is the best for this purpose. So our molecular investigation kept going at Oslo NMBU, where we have screened our samples using a multiplex real-time PCR for the detection of Cyclospora cayetanensis, Toxoplasma gondii, and because Echinococcus multilocularis was already included in this protocol, for Echinococcus multilocularis as well. In addition, at Istituto Superiore di Sanità, we have screened our sample for the detection of Cyclospora cayetanensis using real-time PCR protocol by the FDA, the protocol FDA BAM-19B, and also we have looked for Giardia duodenalis and Cryptosporidium using two conventional PCR methods and sequencing. Finally, in our lab, we have molecularly confirmed the entamoeba samples that we had found positive in microscopy. And we have done this by using a conventional PCR protocol plus sequencing. So what results have we obtained? So first of all, we have identified the cyclospora-like oocyst in a blueberry sample, as we can see in the photo below. Also, we have identified the Tenida egg in a ready-to-eat salad sample, And in addition, we have also identified giardia and entamoeba in both berries and ready-to-eat salad samples. Regarding the molecular investigation results, first of all, we have managed to confirm the two giardia cysts that we had identified microscopically. Overall, we have found 25 samples positive for giardia duodenalis assemblages A and B, 30 positive samples for cryptosporidium belonging to four different species, which are Rayane, Bovis, Shaoi, and Ubiquitum, and these samples were found, these parasites were both detected in berries and ready-to-eat salads. In addition, one blueberry sample was found positive for Cyclospora cayetanensis using both real-time PCR techniques and confirming what we had found in microscopy. The Tenide egg that we had found microscopically was confirmed in the ready-to-eat salad sample where we found Echinococcus multilocularis. Also, one blueberry sample was found positive for Entamoeba histolytica, confirming once again what we had observed. And finally, all pools tested negative for Toxoplasma gondii. At the moment, it is not possible to do complete epidemiological considerations on our data as the statistical analysis is still ongoing. However, what we can tell, summing up our results, is that microscopy and/or molecular tools have revealed that 7.5% of our samples were contaminated by at least one parasite species. So what can we say about our results?
5 minutes left.
Okay. So first of all, the molecular tests that we have carried out have confirmed our microscopy findings. In addition, as to Italy, previous data have been confirmed. In fact, Giardia, Cryptosporidium and Cyclospora cayetanensis have once again been detected in fresh produce. However, Cyclospora cayetanensis in this study was detected in blueberries imported from endemic countries for the first time in Europe. Also, in this study, most of the parasite species were detected for the first time in fresh produce. In fact, animal and zoonotic cryptosporidium species were found in both berries and ready-to-eat salads, and also Echinococcus multilocularis was found in ready-to-eat salads, when we all know that most of the time it had been detected, first of all, in the north of Italy and then in association with wildlife. Because the crops that were found positive, so the crops in question, were cultivated in the south of Italy, we thought that, we were expecting this result to be Echinococcus granulosus granulosus. So we decided to carry out a few more experiments to make sure we could rely on this result. So we've done two things. The first, we got a positive control of Echinococcus granulosus granulosus, and we ran the same real-time PCR that we have used to obtain our positive result, and we obtained a negative one. And the second thing we did, we used our positive sample and tested it using a conventional PCR that targeted Echinococcus granulosus granulosus and also got a negative result. Of course, these are just main considerations because these results are very recent, so we are still interpreting and thinking about these results. So these products have been found, fresh products have been found contaminated in the past and in this study. So when they are sold on the market, they may represent a risk for public health. However, the EU and Italian legislation that covers the consumption of these products only define the microbiological limits for bacteria. The question is, shall protozoans be included in the legislation as well as bacteria? Well, in order to do that, there is a long path, which starts with the risk assessment, which is science-based, which means that in order to reach this goal, we have to gather additional data. and develop rapid and reliable methods for the detection of parasites in different food matrices, which is exactly what we have done in this study. In addition, always in the spirit of gathering additional data, in collaboration with the Rural Economy Group at our university, at the University of Foggia, we have prepared a questionnaire that we will very soon share in our region and in the whole country to assess the trend of consumption of ready-to-eat salads and the risk perception by consumers. And by the way, we would be very happy if you all want to take part in this survey, and we reckon we will be ready by next week, so stay tuned. However, in the meantime, what can we do? Of course, we can try what is in our power to prevent or at least reduce contamination in fresh produce. So we can act in the pre-harvest and in the post-harvest phase with control, such as monitoring the quality of irrigation and processing water, minimizing animal access to crops, still controlling the use of manure as fertilizer, development of chemical and physical disinfection, and last but not least, encourage personal hygiene education and food safety education for food handlers. Also, it is crucial to implement the One Health approach and certainly seek cooperation among different professions to preserve public health. Thank you very much for your attention. I'm just going to steal a couple of more minutes because I think my time might be over. To thank my supervisor, Professor Gian Gaspero at the University of Foggia, and the coordinator of our PhD, Professor Giancarlo Colelli. And now there is a short list of people I really want to thank, like Professor Lucy, Christopher, and Tamirat, and all the staff at the Norwegian University of Life Sciences, not only for collaborating with us, but for hosting me for 6 months, so mainly for their patience. And then I want to thank Dr. Caccio and Anna at Istituto Superiore di Sanità for their help in this project. Certainly, I want to thank everyone at Cremopar, Professor Kringoli, Professor Rinaldi, and Davide for all their cooperation in the microscopy part of the study. And last but not least, Professor Berrilli, who's been very helpful in the entamoeba identification part with the positive controls and all the parcels, and of course, her moral support. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Alessandra.
You are welcome.
It was very interesting presentation.
Thank you.
Brava. So, any question or comments? We have 3 minutes. Okay, no one. And so, can I ask just a curiosity, Alessandra?
Yes.
And do you know which is the kind of disinfectant used in the food industry to clean or to disinfect the salad or the...
Yeah, well, mainly, I mean, I would say it's because like berries are sold, let's say, fresh, whereas ready to eat salads, yes, technically they are sold ready to eat, which means that technically after you buy them, you could eat them without washing. Yes. The system that they use is mainly chlorine added to water in different concentration. And then, as we discussed last week, other methods have been suggested, like ozone, yes, and UV, and especially I mean, even though it's more expensive and more experiments should be done before trying, it is they reckon that using more than one system, like a multi-barrier system, which combines these different methods, certainly may bring good results. So we have to.
Yes, I agree with you. Okay, thank you, Alessandra.